As a little kid, I was quite a tomboy. I liked to go outside and play in the dirt, but my mom always had me dressed up. So even if I was playing in the dirt, I had a big bow in my hair and a dress on. I always looked cute. In my first dance performance, I definitely was not in a costume my mother would approve of. It was yellow and had this horrible hat and it had blue sequins, and I was doing this thing called the duck dance.
When I was a kid, I was a ham. Whenever there's a camera around, I'm always posing, just always entertaining, but at the same time, I was a little bit too animated. When it comes to dancing, I was actually a late bloomer. I started dancing when I was 16, but my first dance performance was playing Leroy in Fame. Even in my first year of dance, I killed it, come on.
The team will be with Jean-Marc.
1, 2, today we're doing the samba. And not any samba. It needs to be hot and spicy. A little sexy. What you want to see in the samba? It's the butt. You want to see the hips. You want to see it coming from the feet, through the knees, and bam! Thank you, man.
Jean-Marc, his method of teaching is crazy. It works, though.
I like the sound of those hips. Each dance have a voice, and the voice of samba have to come out from the hips. Like speakers.
I don't know if I can imagine my hips being speakers. I'm gonna have to try to, I guess.
That's what I'm talking about. They need to sell it with their face and expression. They need to power everything through your feet. You're gonna blow away the audience through the hips. You need to use your hips like speaker, and you have to blow it, pull to the audience, go, pow!
Jean-Marc Formidable. It's about to get loud. Please welcome Caitlynn and Mitchell.
It's also loose as well. So many people, when they're first learning this dance, they get so uptight. And Mitchell, hello! What is going on up there? This dance, when, you know, it's very risky on the show, and often when the male does it, it can often look cheesy. It wasn't, Mitchell! You were nailing those bolts of the action that you did! You were so rhythmical! You were so powerful! You came from a place of strength, and I loved every second of it. You hot tamales out there. Woo!
Kirsten, what did you
shut the front door.
Wow, she scared me.
Shut the back door, shut the door to the garage, shut the door, shut the door. Just shut them off. You shut it down, you shut the door.
She shut it.
You shut your legs, you opened your legs. I'm just saying, shut the front door.
Okay. Good. Good. See? You'd like to close, or air conditioning you'd like to switch off?
You know, we might need some ventilation. We might need some ventilation. Oh. It was so much bass generating from them hips up there. I need y'all to turn the decibels down on that ballroom buckness. Real deal. Yes. Y'all murdered it. You already know. Everybody seen it. Shout out to Jean-Marc.
Yep.
Always delivering. Always. Always.
Thank you.
And Mitchell, you say you are a tardy bloomer. Better late than never, my friend.
Absolutely. Nigel.
I think Jean-Marc last week exposed what his weakness is in the cha-cha. This week, he has exposed your strengths, Mitchell, in the samba. Your samba walk is absolutely incredible. You are, for me, the Chris Rock of So You Think You Can Dance. You bring a really great energy to this whole program, and you've now brought a really great style to this program, so I congratulate you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank you.
Caitlin, very quickly, the articulation of your body is fantastic, and I don't know if you know what I mean by articulation, but in English you'd say the rain in Spain, and everything is perfect. Where you put your body leaves us no doubt that it's going in the right places.
Yes.
Terrific.
Thank you.